All right. Hey, good evening, everybody. My name is Paul Leon. I'm the mayor of the City of Ontario. Welcome to Ontario Town Square and the Showband's performance of Music Under the Stars, featuring the music of John Williams and Henry Mancini. Tonight's concert is sponsored by Gary and Miriam Keith. Where are they? Hi, Gary. I haven't seen you in a long time. Good to see you. It's now a pleasure to introduce my co-host this evening, retired city manager of the City of Ontario, Mr. Al Bowling.
Good evening. I am delighted to be co-hosting this exciting performance with Paul. The show band has assembled an exciting repertoire of movie themes composed by John Williams and Henry Mancini. In addition, show band assistant director Pat Arnold and musician dancer Kathy Soderlund will be featured soloists on the program. The show band is delighted to honor the recipients of the Jack Mercer Brass Scholarships. The awards are given annually to middle school brass students who plan to continue their music education in high school and beyond.
The first soloist is Jasmine Chung from Wiltsey Middle School. She has been playing baritone for 2 years and currently plays in the school symphonic band and marching band, where she holds a position of lead baritone. Her most recent accomplishment is being selected by audition as one of the winners of the Jack Mercer Brass Scholarship.
Jasmine Tiang, and I'm going to be playing Country Gardens, a traditional English folk song.
Jasmine. Our next soloist is Madeline Martinez from Vinadanks Middle School. She has been playing trumpet since the fourth grade and currently plays in the school's concert band. where she holds the position of first trumpet and section leader. She is honored in being selected as one of the winners of this year's Jack Mercer Scholarship. Her favorite hobbies are playing various genres of music on her trumpet and reading novels. Her goal is to attend Juilliard School of Music in New York. And here's Madeline.
And I'll be playing Rock Around the Clock, Words of Music by Jimmy D. Knight and Maxie Friedman, arranged by Eric Ostwin.
Third soloist is Luis Lozano. Luis is a seventh grader. He began playing music this September at Grace Yokley School, which is part of the Mountain View School District in Ontario. Luis likes playing video games and traveling, and of course, playing his trumpet. He will be performing Little Brown Jug.
Hello, my name is Luis Lozano. I'll be performing Little Brown Jug as a traditional folk sounds.
Uh-huh.
Our final soloist is Elijah Aviles from Wiltsie Middle School, and he has been playing trumpet since he was a fifth grader. Elijah continues to play in the Ray Wiltsie Middle School Symphonic Band and Marching Band, where he currently holds the position of lead trumpet. In April, he was awarded the Most Outstanding Musicianship Award at the Forum Music Festival in Fullerton, California. Elijah is delighted to have been selected as one of the winners of the Jack Mercer Brass Scholarship. His future goal is to become a member of the Blue Devils or Carolina Crown and to join a professional mariachi ensemble.
My name is Elijah Aviles, and today I'll be playing the Etude number 7 from the Rubik supplementary book.
Another soloist for the evening is Nathan Gonzalez from Wiltsie Middle School. He's been playing trumpet for 2 years and currently plays in the school symphonic band and marching band, where he holds a position of second trumpet. His most recent accomplishment is being selected via audition as one of the winners of the Jack Mercer Brass Scholarship. Let's give a hand to Nathan.
Hi, my name is Nathan, and I'm going to play Serenade from Don Giovanni by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart.
Thank you.
Let's have a rousing round of applause for each of our talented Jack Mercer Brass Scholarship recipients. Let's also have a round of applause for their instructors, Denise Dominguez, Emmerich Gohn, and Karen Greenwood.
John Williams. His career has spanned 7 decades. He has composed some of the most popular, recognizable, and critically acclaimed film scores in cinema history. Williams' early work as a film composer includes Valley of the Dolls, The Cowboys, The Towering Inferno, and The Sugarland Express. He received 5 Academy Awards for Best Original Score for Fiddler on the Roof, Jaws, Star Wars, E.T., The Extra Terrestrial, and Schindler's List. Other memorable film scores include Close Encounters of the Third Kind, Indiana Jones, Jurassic Park, Saving Private Ryan, War Horse, Superman, 3 Harry Potter films, and The Fabelmans.
This evening, the show band will perform 3 medleys of John Williams's music that contain many of the theme songs from his film scores. Included is a tenor saxophone solo performed by Pat Arnold to Williams's love theme from the movie Cinderella Liberty, entitled Nice to Be Around. The show band will also perform Dry Your Tears, Africa, from Williams's film score to Amistad.
The show band opens the concert with an exciting medley of John Williams movie themes. Included the first movement of the John Williams trilogy are Welcome to Jurassic Park, theme from Schindler's List, and the Raiders March. It is now my pleasure to introduce director Dr. Gay Petruccelli and the outstanding musicians of the show band.
Before we go on, thank you for coming this evening. I want to also recognize one more teacher from the Ontario Montclair School District. That's Eufemio Escalante. So, Eufemio, if you're still here, great job with your students. Thank you.
Thank you.
The show band continues with an arrangement of popular Williams' movie themes, including in a medley entitled John Williams in Concert. The collection of themes includes the Mission theme, the Imperial March, Star Wars, Cantina Band, Olympic Spirit, theme from Jaws, and theme from E.T. Sit back and enjoy the music.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know about you, but that second to the last song had gave me chills. I don't ever want to go in the ocean again. I was looking around here to see if there's any coming at me from behind there. Anyway, great job, folks. Amistad is a historical drama film based on the events in the 1839 Spanish slave ship La Amistad. And I personally studied this case, and there's so much involved. It's not just that slaves commandeered a ship, mutinied, if you would. They weren't part of the overall running of the ship. They shouldn't have been on the ship. They were kidnapped in the first place. They were in the ocean waters. Were they close enough to Cuba to be considered in international waters, or were they in Cuban waters? Was it an American issue, or was it a Cuban issue? I mean, so many things were going on that good people had to rise up and do the right thing at the right time when everything looked wrong. And I tell you, if you haven't seen the movie, see it. If you've never read the book, read it. If you've never read about it, read about it. It's a great case in history. The essential plot of the movie involved men to tribesmen who were abducted for the slave trade and managed to gain control of the captor ship off the coast of Cuba. The John Williams score featured a somber theme that captured the essence of the movie's plot. The show band, under the direction of David Grasmick, will now perform Dry Your Tears, Africa. Thank you.
to leave John Williams for the moment and draw our attention to one of the most talented and versatile musicians in the show band, saxophonist and dancer Kathy Soderlund. Kathy is a most capable musician and an outstanding dancer who has entertained show band audiences for years with her style, energy, and creative choreography. Several years ago, Dr. Petrocelli composed a tango just for her. Sit back and enjoy Tango de Amor.
Those things in her hand, those castanets. You don't hear very often people play castanets anymore, huh? And what a great job. And they don't know how to play, you know? So, a great job. Sometimes I think you gotta be old enough to know what they are. It's a good job, thank you. So, in 1973, a film was produced that tells the story of a sailor who falls in love with a lady who has a dubious reputation and becomes a surrogate father for her 10-year-old son. The movie is entitled Cinderella Liberty, with the musical score by John Williams. The score was written during the first half of William's career and clearly displayed his artistry in composing a love song utilizing a small instrumental ensemble. In the movie, the theme was performed on the harmonica. Tonight, you will hear the beautiful melody played on the tenor saxophone by Pat Arnold. Please join me in giving him a round of applause as he performs Nice to Be Around.
Thank you.
Wow, let's hear for smooth Pat Arnold. Speaking of smooth, it is now my pleasure to introduce the president of the Friends in the Show Band, Mr. Gary Ovid.
Well, good evening, everyone. I hope you're enjoying the concert tonight. My goodness, there is no doubt that the city's investment in this band shell at this park down square is paying great dividends, because you're hearing wonderful music. And you hear some other music, too. And we've heard some overhead. And that's because the airport's busy, which is a good thing, only when you're playing a concert. Yeah, you know. But anyway. The mayor could probably stop that if he wanted to. He's doing a good job. I won't require him to do that. Well, we want to thank the many people that play such an important role in putting on each of our concerts. We are thankful to the Showband production team, which has a hardworking staff, including the librarians Miriam Keith, Gary Keith, Bill Bescoby, Susan Petricelli, and Crystal Leonard, as well as stage manager Homero Chavez, as you saw him adjusting the stand for the each of the students who were playing for their scholarships. The assistant band manager Steve Collins as well. They all work really hard to set everything up and then tear it down and take it back and bring it over here. That's a lot of work, and we really appreciate their efforts. None of them are paid for this, by the way. Karen Greenwood and Magnolia Video Productions and the City of Ontario play such an important role in everything. The city, as I mentioned before, outstanding venue right here. The Inland Valley Daily Bulletin and the Chaffey Adult School also are partners in this. Showband photographer Steve Davis is walking around taking some great pictures, and we appreciate that. Our lithographer Scott Noble produced the concert program that you're looking at tonight. The Chaffey High School Junior ROTC program, the Corps of Naval Cadets, were out here earlier handing out programs and ushering you in if you needed that help. They do things all over the place. They do over a thousand assignments, if you will, over the year that they're helping out somebody who needs young people to either do the colors, bring the colors in, or many other things as well. We really appreciate them. And then tonight you were entertained pre-concert by the Ontario Chaffey Saxophone Band Quartet for their pre-concert recital. Very nice. We've heard some good saxophone tonight, haven't we now? Pat Arnold, wow, fantastic. Just did a great job on that solo. We also want to thank the generous show sponsors that are on the back of your program, and they're all listed there. You too can support the show band by taking an information card or an envelope, which is at the information table over there, and that is sitting right next to the Hungry Tuba. Hungry Tuba is 100 years old this year, and you might want to wish the Hungry Tuba a happy birthday by putting in a little bit of the green stuff. So if you think about it that way, love to see it. By the way, this is a cornet. This is Gabe Petricelli's father's cornet. And it was manufactured in, or crafted, if you will, in the 1800s. So it's an old horn, but old horns are still good horns. We'd like to thank the VIPs who came tonight. They include, of course, the mayor of the City of Ontario, Paul Leon, the Honorable Paul Leon. I've got the microphone. Our city treasurer, Mr. Jim Melheiser. He's also a board member for the Ontario Chaffey Community Show Band. He's our treasurer. As well, Chris Cruz is in playing some great music on the Uplin School District Board. Sue Ovid, my favorite one. She's in the back. She keeps me organized. And she is the president of the Chaffey Joint Union High School District Board right now. And the friends, I mentioned Gary Keith is the secretary for our friends. Also, he and Miriam are the sponsors of tonight's concert. We really appreciate them. Assistant Superintendent Dr. Kern Orduro. Dr. Kern Orduro is up there. Al Bowling, who is our vice president and doing an excellent job tonight. And I think I've got most everybody. If I miss someone, let me know tonight sometime before you go home. All right, I will turn it back over. I know you've got, you're getting a little cool out there, so we want some hot music to be played so that you guys can warm up. Thank you.
Thanks, Gary.
Thank you, Gary.
And give it up for Gary Ovitt, and we're right next to his house, the Ovitt Family Library. Oh, that's not where it is. Anyway.
Thank you, Gary. Another famous American film composer was Henry Mancini. He became a household name in the industry with the success of his theme song for the TV series Peter Gunn. Mancini also wrote many popular songs such as Moon River, The Days of Wine and Roses, the Pink Panther theme, Love Theme to Romeo and Juliet, Charade, Baby Elephant Walk, and many more. He was also a very successful film composer with credits that include Breakfast at Tiffany's, the Pink Panther films, A Shot in the Dark, Charade, Arabesque, The Great Race, The Glenn Miller Story, and Dear Heart, to name just a few. The talented musicians of the Showband will now perform the theme song written by Mancini for the 1963 film Charade. Taking the podium is George Osorio. Thank you.
In 1966, Mancini wrote the score to a comedy spy thriller that featured an innocent and ordinary man thrust into dangerous situations. The movie generally was met with mixed reviews, even though it starred Gregory Peck and Sophia Loren. Mancini's score was well received, and the film's title, the title theme, became a hit. The Showband will now perform. Will you all stand in arabesque? It's a ballet move, you know. Anyway, they're gonna play arabesque for us. Thank you. I'm just joking. You don't really have to stand. Only I do.
Yeah, you probably take that away.
Wonderful. The 1963 film, The Pink Panther, featured a song in a samba rhythm composed by Mancini and lyricist Franco Migliacci. In the movie, the song was used. The song was used in many different forms and scenes. The lively melody was a perfect fit for the film. It became a hit and was later recorded by a host of vocal and instrumental artists. Please sit back and enjoy It Had Better Be Tonight.
It is now my pleasure to introduce Showband director, Dr. Gabe Petricelli.
Thank you. Thank you, Fireman Leon. Thank you.
Doctor, somebody with the sound needs to turn off all of the reverb and everything because you're echoing and I'm reverbing. And it's making it very difficult for us to use our mics.
Okay.
If somebody's
I'll try
over
to
there.
Talk softly.
No, I hear you 10 times.
Well,
that's okay.
It started out, it was an interesting day after spending a week in, where were we, Susan? In Nashville. I had my doubts about fitting into this tuxedo. So I was ready to wear my sharkskin suit that I bought in Newark. But I didn't think that people would stay if I showed up with that. So anyway, the good news is I was able to fit into my tuxedo. So A heartfelt thanks to the musicians behind me, the Ontario Chaffey Community Show Band. They're the greatest show band in all the land. There they are. Many thanks to President Gary Ovid and the esteemed board members that work with him. They're the friends of the show band, and their support is unwavering. Thank you to each of you. Sue Owen, for all her assistance. Can't do without you, Sue. Thank you. Generosity of Gary and Miriam Keith for sponsoring our performance this evening. Thank you for your generosity. Our distinguished narrators, Mayor Paul Leon, and the dapper Al Bowling. Also, I want to mention my assistant director, David Chaffin, for all his work in the multimedia and also preparing all of the certificates and the frames and all of the scripts and everything. David is invaluable. David? Just coming back from hip surgery. I'm glad to have him back. Also, I want to recognize our two talented conductors this evening, George Osorio, stand up, George, and David Grabsman. And also my sincere thanks to our timpanist, Stephen Christopher. Stephen is substituting for Bob, who's now, I think he's playing with the Norway show band. Somewhere in Norway or Sweden. Also, I was very happy that we were able to find a concert to feature our brass scholarship recipients. These are wonderful kids. They're in the middle school. Their teachers work very hard to get them to where they have the presence to stand in front of a whole audience like you and perform. So very grateful for that. I want to thank our two soloists this evening. Fantastic dancer, Kathy Soderlund. And my dear friend, tenor saxophone and assistant director, Pat Arnold. And I also want to thank John D'Amico. John, thank you. And finally, I want to thank all of you for coming this evening. Appreciate your attendance tonight, and I hope to see you again either in Memorial Day or in our June concert. Okay, guys, take it away.
All right. So on behalf of Dr. Petricelli and the entire show band family, the City of Ontario, Chaffey Adult School, Chaffey High School, and my co-host, as you heard, the Al Bowling, I want to sincerely thank you for spending your evening with us. We hope that you have enjoyed tonight's performance and look forward to seeing all of you once again at Bellevue Memorial Park on Memorial Day at 10 a.m. and the show band's final indoor performance of the concert season on June 17th at Gardner Spring Auditorium on the campus of Chaffey High School.
Now we return to the exciting music of John Williams to conclude this evening's concert. The melody includes We're Looking Good, The March for the Special Olympics, The Cowboys, The Dance of the Witches, and Olympic Fanfare and Theme. Please give a rousing round of applause to the musicians of the show band as they perform John Williams' Evening at the Pops.
Thank you. altos. Thank you.
right. All right, all right. Let's hear it. Let's hear it for this great, great show band. What's the next one is? When? When's our next date for a concert? Yeah, but that's June 17th. So we'd like to thank you for being here tonight. We'd like to invite you to our summer concert series, which will be Wednesday nights, coming up starting at the end of this month, really. Our first concert, by the way, will be Queen Nation. If you like Queen, come and see those guys. Our second one, if you like Bruno Mars, this guy is Bruno Mars. I mean, I've seen him. He's amazing. And we have a lot of concerts throughout, including on the 24th of July, we're going to have a mariachi professional Hispanic concert here that'll knock your socks off. So, with all of that being said, we'd like to thank you again for joining us tonight in the cold but hot music we had all night. Thank you, Doctor. Thank you, Showband. Thank you, all of you, for being here. Thank you.